When I first lost my eyesight, I was 16 years old. It happened overnight. It wasn't gradual or anything like that.
You lost your eyesight overnight?
I had 20/20 vision one night, went to bed, woke up the next morning with 80% vision loss. I've developed a feel where I can feel if the club face was slightly open or if it shut.
Right.
And if I felt like it shut and it hit the toe, then I know it missed right. So just little things like that I've picked up on over the years playing with my vision loss.
Well, it's definitely fall in Calgary. I love this time of the year. It is super nice outside right now, actually. Last year, a couple of weeks ago last year at this time, we had like 6 inches of snow. It's hit and miss this time of the year in Calgary. But today, with the warm weather, we're gonna continue with our Unsung Heroes series. I've been having a blast with these things. It's a ton of fun. We're gonna meet Keither today. Keither is actually legally blind, and he's the Canadian and world golf champion, and I am really excited to learn more about his experiences golfing, how he got into the sport, and what it's like golfing with him. So this series that I'm doing, actually, we call the Unsung Heroes, and the philosophy behind it is people that work for us. A lot of times I feel like in golf are unsung heroes. They come with great, interesting backgrounds like yourself, and they work in the industry because they love it. Golf's your passion.
Yeah,
I can tell.
Anywhere, put me anywhere on a golf course and I feel at home.
You're in your happy place.
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
Actually, when I first lost my eyesight, I was 16 years old. It happened overnight. It wasn't gradual or anything like that.
You lost your eyesight overnight.
I had 20/20 vision one night, went to bed, woke up the next morning with 80% vision loss. A ton of doctor's appointments and stuff like that.
Right.
Where they were trying to figure out what happened. All they could figure out was it was a virus that attacked my optic nerve.
Okay.
So I just have like the scarring and you know, the damage that had been done is still there. The way I started learning that I'm gonna feel the shot.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna see it. So
right.
If I can learn what the feel that I want to hit, if I can just repeat that feel every
right.
time and just get my body to remember that's the feeling you want every
the
single
muscle
time.
Memory, right?
Yeah. And you know, if I do miss one, I can usually tell, you know, if I've hit it on the heel or the toe a little bit.
Right.
I've developed a feel where I can feel if the club face was slightly open or if it shut.
Right.
And if I felt like it shut and it hit the toe, then I know it missed right.
Right.
So just little things like that I've picked up on over the years playing with my vision loss. Doing, you know, with the whole COVID and everything,
right.
is I would have my caddy put hers or his head right behind my arm here, and I would line up and I would go, you know, is that my line? Is
no,
that the
yeah,
middle
you
of fairway?
More right of that.
More right of that.
Right, more still. More. I would say right there.
Down the shaft line?
Yeah, right down there.
Okay.
That's just right of the, or even slightly more right. Yeah.
Is that that's where the bunker is?
Yeah, that's just slightly right of the bunker, and I think you'd probably hit the bunker.
Okay.
And it's a dogleg right, so it opens up right.
Okay.
Okay.
And then what I'll do is now that I've kind of positioned my ball, I'll tell my guide, I'll be like, is that the line there?
Yep, that's bang on.
Right? So yep. I kind of just pick something, like any golfer would do.
Okay.
Pick something on the, now that I figured out where, right? And then I know my line, and I know,
that's your line.
A little bit left of that's fairway still.
Yep.
I don't want to be too much right of that.
You're where you just marked that line is perfect.
Yeah. So then I'll just, and I usually do hit a little draw with my driver, so I'll try to account for finishing on that line. So I'll take it just a little left. That one felt really open and toey.
You did hit it a little bit left, but I think you're going to be okay. Because of the toey, it probably didn't go quite as far.
Yeah.
So definitely. I think you're okay, actually. Oh, I'm with you. But I nailed that, so sit down, ball. I think there's two of us. There's two of us right here. Look at that. Just like I thought. Yeah. side, but really close.
You called it. It was low. Even past the hole.
I got a feeling we're going to get some pars and birdies coming
up
here.
We're just getting warmed up.
Just getting warmed up. Oh, that's money. That is money. Favorite. I mean, it's one of the best par fours in Alberta, in my mind.
Now, would you say this is gonna break that way?
This is everything on this putt because it's fast.
I think I'm just gonna tap it.
Yeah.
That might be too hard. That looks good.
Yo, all the way around the hole and wow. In. Do you know Lisa Longball?
I have met her, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So I had a long drive competition with her on this tee behind us. She freaking beat me. And I hit one pretty dang good.
And she hits it a long ways.
Yeah. Okay, so there's kind of a bunker up on the left there, but you can hit it over the bunker.
Okay. What do I need here, 280?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And then just right up the middle here?
Yeah, I would go slightly left of that if you're gonna hit a draw. Not quite that far.
So if I, right off the middle of the tee box in front of us,
A little bit right of that.
Okay.
That should be perfect. You nailed that.
That felt good.
That's perfect. Uh-oh. I'll take that all day long from 216. Middle of the green.
Perfect.
Take it. Well, Kiefer, that was an absolute blast. I had a ton of fun. Hopefully you did as well.
I did.
Yeah? Good. I'd love to play with you again, but you know, you said something to me that kind of struck a chord. I haven't done this in any of our series so far, but I want to contribute $1,000 to your cause to help you in your golf ambitions.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, I want to see what you can do with it, and hopefully that's a help for you.
Oh, that's huge. I mean, anything would be a huge help, but
right.
Yeah, that's amazing. Thank you so much.
We're going to connect soon on that and get that taken care of. Guys, thanks for watching today. Another series of Unsung Heroes, or another episode, I should say. Hope you enjoyed that. Please comment, like, subscribe. We'll see you next time.